Hello. Marinette barely had time to say the magic words when her body was covered in pink light, transforming her into the superhero Ladybug. But where does her clothes, purse, or backpack go? All characters, of course, wear clothes. But often it's not just a t-shirt, but a sweater, shoes, and even a jacket. So where does their clothes disappear to during transformation? Today we'll try to figure out this question, so hurry to the channel and ring the bell. It's cool. Truth be told, this question has been bothering me for a long time. Initially, it was assumed that a costume appears over regular clothes, hiding everything underneath. I get a super suit made of invulnerable fabric and magical accessories. But no, that can't be true. Ladybug's costume is very sleek and tight, it fits her entire body, and even if we assume that the clothes remain, it would surely be noticeable through the costume, at least the outlines of a jacket or jeans. Moreover, Ladybug would hardly find it convenient to move around and perform complex tricks in such clothes. But let's suppose that the clothes do stay in place. Then where do her purse and shoes go? This fact makes me think more deeply, to think with my head. It's clear that all this is magic and sorcery. But if the hero's clothes disappear, where do they go? I spent many hours searching for an answer on the internet, but I didn't find anything conclusive. So I came up with the following: when Marinette says the magic words, her clothes, unwillingly, begin to transform into energy, then absorbed by the talismans. Most likely, the talismans exist in an abstract world, similar to what we saw in the episode Sandboy, where magical items from the box came to us through a portal. Okay, something similar exists in the Miraculous Stones. Remember Backwater, episode where she hid a letter? In it, she can store an infinite number of things and objects that can fit through the narrow hole of this yo-yo. It's a pity that the authors didn't describe in detail how it works and what is on the other end of the portal. Anyway, there's definitely no clothes in it. Perhaps it is the Miraculous that takes on all the things that the character is wearing. Even if turning into a superhero involves magic, things just can't disappear into thin air, they move to another place. It would be funny to see the elements in Marinette's clothes. In this photo, she just lacks shoes to complete the look. However, jokes aside, this theory cannot be real. If we look at Max's transformation, we see a new hairstyle, white dreadlocks, which hints at the following. All the clothes of the characters, including their hair, transform into a new image. So the clothes don't disappear, they just take on a new form in the form of a costume, mask, and hairstyle. It is also worth noting that the same Kwame looks different on different heroes. If we got a little confused, I remembered Mr. Bug, Adrian, in Ladybug's costume. He had black inserts on the sides and biceps, which Ladybug didn't have. This can be explained scientifically, but you will be very bored. So I'll say it in two words. All things in the universe are made of the same atoms, which, essentially, are eternal and can transform into other things. Therefore, transforming clothes into a costume is quite real. In the future, such technology will definitely exist. As for the world of Ladybug, there is no getting around magic here. Their costumes are very strong and protect their bodies from damage, cold, and heat. But what's under the costume then? Surely there's nothing there? Personally, I would be uncomfortable running around naked. In general, all transformations in the series can be explained as magic, and each costume is just perfectly tailored to fit. The hero's body is almost like a real one. It's just that in the episode where Ladybug and Cat switch places, showing us that Marinette is beautiful in any look. Yes, beginners are lucky, yes, they're just jealous. But the thing is, the superhero costume doesn't press on the shoulders as much as her own does. It doesn't strangle her in the shoulders. Maybe it's made of a different material? Or did the Kwame guess the size of the costume wrong? He looks bolder. All this is unclear. But one thing is clear, their costume has quite ordinary physical properties, although it is created by a magical method. And if you want to find out more about what Ladybug's and Cat Noir's costumes are made of, watch my video on the channel by clicking the link in the description. It's very interesting what you think about this issue. Where does the clothing of superheroes go? Does it disappear or transform into a costume? Don't be lazy and write in the comments. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel. Bye, my friends.